In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how the use of Coverity in your Jazz and Rational Team Concert deployment will help you increase developer and testing efficiency, leading to faster time to market with lower overall cost while maintaining your valuable reputation. I'm sure you're familiar with the reality of developing software. In the rush to market, teams need to work with condensed release cycles that necessarily leave less time for QA and increase the risk of releasing code with known or unknown issues. The IBM Rational solution provides a suite of tools for managing the project from requirements to release. As problems are discovered in testing, they're fed back into development for fixes, and continuous integration helps run the builds and tests more often. The Coverity solution is focused on finding more defects in development. It helps you find and fix defects while they're still easy and cheap, and ensure your products release with minimal trips through QA and audit. When used with the Rational platform, Coverity establishes more automated analysis in the development and build phases. These results are immediately fed back to developers for a quick fix, ensuring defects are fixed before the code progresses to later stages. Long, repeated cycles between development and QA are minimized. This also creates artifacts in the CLM platform that improve manageability. Taken together, the Coverity Rational solution enables you to reach market sooner by increasing efficiency. Even better, you accomplish this at lower overall cost and without sacrificing quality, security, or your reputation. We're going to track the life of a particular work item. Deb, one of the developers on this team, has identified a defect that is blocking progress on a few other issues. She's discussed it with Bob, our manager, and that's where we come in. We start our story with our manager, Bob, who spends a lot of his time in the RTC web interface. He's using the project dashboard to see how development is progressing. They're just getting started on their sprint, as you can tell from the burndown and work items charts. Since he's interested specifically in that sprint, he opens up the plan for sprint one. We can see that a number of activities have been created and assigned to this sprint. A few developers have started work on their items, while others are waiting to be assigned activities. Bob was just speaking with Deb, and even though she already has a couple of other activities on her plate, Bob creates a new work item for her defect. Let's just call it Fix the Defect, Please. She'll know what it means. It should be an easy fix, so let's allocate an hour and save it. Since he's working in the context of a sprint, the work item will be immediately shared with Deb. Bob can continue his work of allocating and balancing the sprint activities across the team. Now, Deb. Deb, as usual, is using RTC in Eclipse. She's reviewing her work items while waiting for Bob to authorize the fix they discussed. She refreshes her list, and the new item appears in her inbox. She's been waiting for it, so she accepts it into the current sprint and makes it her current work item. Eclipse agrees that it is her current work item, so she goes to the relevant code and gets to work on the fix. For purposes of this demonstration, let's assume that commenting out this line of code constitutes an appropriate fix. Now that Deb has the fix in her private workspace, we can see an outgoing change in her pending changes. Since this defect is blocking progress for other developers, she wants to deliver her fix so they can get to work on their blocked items. Bob's team is practicing continuous integration, and delivering that fix also tells the Jazz server to kick off a build. We can actually track the progress of that build in the Builds panel. We can see some older builds, and when we refresh, we can see the new build as well. This is where the Coverity integration comes in. During the build, the Jazz server will also have Coverity analyze the code and manage findings in Coverity Connect. The analysis goes well beyond the types of issues found by fine bugs and PMD, identifying real defects, things like resource leaks, null dereferences, concurrency problems, and more. The last step in the build is to create work items in RTC corresponding to any problems found in the analysis. That way, the IBM platform remains the authoritative source of team management, handling everything from requirements to activity planning to progress and status. Now that the build is finished, Deb refreshes her work items and sees a couple of new items. Note how they were automatically assigned to Deb since she committed the change and is responsible for the code where the issues were found. Opening up one of these issues, we get a summary of what's wrong. If more context is needed, Deb can get all the details via this link to Coverity Connect. Coverity Connect provides a detailed explanation of the problem in the context of the code. In this case, we have an overridden method that fails to call the superclass implementation. That's not always a problem, of course, but in this case, we see that there are two other classes that extend the same base class, and both of those call the superclass in their override of this method. That's a pretty good clue that this class should do the same. Note the information in the upper right that explains why that might be a problem and how to fix it. There's even a link to the industry standard CWE database for more commentary and examples. If we're not sure how to deal with this in our code, we could view those other classes to see why they call the superclass. We can also browse through the source, perhaps viewing the definition of the base class or expanding functions called by this method. In this case, the defect is exactly right. Our pretend fix consisted of commenting out the call to the superclass, which apparently introduces a new set of problems. We have a number of attributes that we can use to manage and track this issue, which are synced back to RTC as well. For brevity, we won't follow this process all the way to a final clean fix. Suffice it to say, Deb will redo the same process to correct her fix and get a clean build. Back to Bob. We've just seen the life of a work item when using RTC and Coverity, and that's happening many times a day over perhaps many developers. You may recall that Bob uses the project dashboards to manage priorities, workload, and other aspects of the project. In fact, because the integration pulls artifacts from Coverity into RTC, those same dashboards can help him understand not only the status of project sprints and builds, but of the code itself. The Coverity dashboard provides a wealth of information about the code. For example, he can see how problems in the code are classified, their impact, and distribution among developers. Since they're just like other artifacts in RTC, Coverity issues can be linked with other issues and follow RTC workflows. This dashboard includes a widget showing which Coverity issues are blocking progress on other activities. You can even follow the status of the builds. That provides nice visibility into the status of your development projects in the context of individual projects. The Coverity integration also enables you to view those coding artifacts in the context of the enterprise, spanning project, team, and even supplier boundaries, to better understand where risk lies in your code portfolio. Are there business units accumulating significant technical debt? Which teams are going to need additional resources to integrate acquired software that wasn't written to your exacting standards? This was, of course, a simple demo focused on a typical scenario. Every development team is unique, and every organization has unique challenges. Coverity and Rational Team Concert are customized to work in your culture and environment, enabling you to increase developer and testing efficiency, ultimately reaching market faster with lower overall cost while maintaining your valuable reputation.